world-class athlete at only 21 years, Simon Keith was brought in some life-changing news. The soccer star needed a heart transplant. Now at 50, he's one of the longest living transplant recipients, and his story is being shared on ESPN tonight.
Here with the details is Simon himself. He's the chief operating officer of the Nevada Donor Network. How are you?
Hi, I'm good, except for Sean threw me under the bus at 50.
Well,
killing
I'm sorry.
Me.
We'll talk about
I don't
that
believe
later.
It either.
Now, we'll get to the Nevada Donor Network also in just a moment. Yeah. But first, tell us about your story. What happened to you that you needed a transplant?
Well, so as a young athlete, yeah. I just, bad luck, really, I caught a cold. It was a virus that attacked my heart. And
wow.
Yeah, it was crazy. I was sick for about sort of on and off a year and a half, still playing at a very high level, and then things went south, and I eventually needed a heart transplant. Yeah, crazy.
You were playing for UNLV, right?
I was not. I was playing up in Canada.
Okay.
Well, I was playing in England, then to Canada, but I actually came to UNLV right after my transplant.
Wow.
Sort of to rehab and.
And
get some sun on my face and drink some beer.
Yeah, you picked Vegas because you just had been here before?
My brother was playing on the UNLV soccer team, so I came down, and I actually came down to visit, and I kind of looked around and went, wow, this might be a good place to rehab.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I mean, where else would you go to rehab for a heart transplant, right?
This predates rehab the pool party.
Right,
you
exactly.
were like doing it
old school.
Old school.
Exactly.
Old school Vegas.
You make it sound so simple, but you went through a lot of procedures, you know, taking care of yourself, medications, doctor's visits.
Yeah.
It was tough.
Yeah, it was. It's, you know, it's not all sort of rainbows and unicorns, right? I mean, we got to take care of ourselves. All transplant patients do.
Of course.
And touch wood, I'm very fortunate. You know, I'm in year 30, which is sort of unheard of. But I'm sort of stubborn and in my own set my ways. So it sort of works for me. It's all good. Yeah.
Well, I know ESPN, this is going to be really cool. E60, one of my favorite programs in ESPN, a documentary series. They're going to have a portion of the E60 tonight on your story. Tell us about it.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's taken us about a year to film it. They do a great job. You know, it's in over 100 million households in the United States. So, you know, it's really not about me. It's really about organ donation and saving lives and inspiring other people. And I just happen to be the guy that is living inside this body. But it's cool. These are great stories. They do a phenomenal job. And it's exciting. It's going to be good.
Now, you're one of the longest living heart transplant recipients. And obviously, that's going to be documented in the documentary tonight. But is that just crazy to you to think about that? And why do you think you've been able to do it, to survive?
I think I'm just dumb enough to be successful. And I say that really. I really mean that. I say that. I don't overthink it. I don't... I just am who I am. I work out all the time, and I eat healthy, and I don't do
you
that
because of that.
You have
a positive attitude, yeah. too, don't you?
You don't let it define you.
Straightforward, yeah. man. Just let's go. Yeah. Yeah. And some luck. Dumb luck.
But listen, nothing wrong with luck. If you can get it, why not?
Yeah.
Considering you just celebrated your 25th birthday.
Right.
You're welcome.
Yeah,
how did you celebrate?
Actually, we had a great day. We actually went down to Las Vegas Sign, and we had a big 50th cake.
Oh,
and,
there
oh, wow,
you
nice.
And yeah, it was so great.
Check
and we had
the cake out. Nice.
Yeah. It was cool. And, you know, we had a proclamation, and it was awesome. We got to celebrate with the Nevada Donor Network team. And,
excellent.
And, you know, again, this is not about me. It's just fun stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, you head up the Nevada Donor Network. Can you explain what you do?
I can. I think I can. I'll give it a shot.
Okay.
We're responsible for recovering and coordinating and allocating all the life-saving organs and tissue recovered in the state of Nevada. And we've had a remarkable transformation in the organization. We've gone from a very low-performing organization in the last 3 years to we recover more organs in Nevada than anywhere else in the world.
No kidding.
Per capita.
Wow.
What organs can be used?
Out of every heroic donor, we can recover 8 organs. So your heart, your lungs, your kidneys, that's 5, Sean.
Yeah.
I'll count one. A liver, pancreas, and there's one more I can
retina.
Think of. And you know, well, those aren't organs, right?
Oh, okay.
That's
organs.
Tissue. So we recover corneas and we restore sight.
Okay.
And we recover tissues like bone for spinal surgeries or ACLs for athletic injuries or whatever. So,
and
yeah.
without the transplant or the organs, other people wouldn't Lots survive
line,
or
yeah.
would have a tough time.
Yeah, yeah. There's you know, over 100,000 people in the United States waiting for a life-saving organ, which sounds like this big number, but if you're that person on the list, it's the most important thing. So
mm-hmm.
every organ counts, and And of course, we encourage people to donate. And
you got about 30 register. Seconds left. Yep. Beyond the Nevada Donor Network, you also have the Simon Keith Foundation.
I do.
Tell us
I do.
About this.
One of the funnest things I do, I find kids who have had organ transplants, and we actually just write checks to sports organizations or activities so
awesome.
They can get back and play.
Awesome.
It's awesome. So much fun.
Yeah, you're doing
it.
Great work.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's great.
Thank you very much.
Thank Happy
you.
Birthday.
Thank
Happy
you.
Belated birthday, yes.
25.
Catch Keith's story on ESPN E60. It airs tonight at 5 p.m. on ESPN. Meantime, to learn more about the Nevada Donor Network, check out the website on your screen.